Americans have long seen their soul, their failures and their triumphs, through their writers. No other country has produced such a noble body of literature as the United States. Hello, I'm Jane Kaczmarek, and welcome to the Great American Authors Series. This generation of writers witnessed and participated in World War II, Korea, the Cold War, the Civil Rights Movement, and Vietnam. These experiences shaped them intellectually, spiritually, and emotionally in ways that were translated into their writing. With the Civil Rights Movement in full swing, Black Americans were uncertain as to who they were. No one better expressed this limbo than Lorraine Hansberry and her play, A Raisin in the Sun.
You haven't even looked at it. You haven't even looked at it, and you don't even have to speak on it again? Well, you tell that to my boy tonight when you put him to sleep on the living room couch. And you tell it to him in the morning when his mother goes out of here to take care of somebody else's kids. And tell it to me when we want some curtains or some drapes and you sneak out of here and go work in somebody's kitchen. All I want is to make a future for this family. All I want is to be able to stand in front of my boy like my father never was able to do to me and tell him that he'll be somebody in this world besides a servant and a chauffeur. Huh? You tell me that, huh?
No public expression better captured the angst and dilemma facing American blacks, and the American black male in particular, than Lorraine Hansberry's play, A Raisin in the Sun. When her play opened in New York City on March 11, 1959, it achieved a number of firsts. It was the first play written by a black woman to be produced on Broadway. It won the New York Drama Critics Circle Award, and Hansberry was the youngest writer and the first black to receive this award. Lorraine Hansberry was born on May 19, 1930, in Chicago, the daughter of a well-known real estate broker. She grew up in Woodlawn on Chicago's South Side. Her parents were intellectuals and activists, providing her with diverse experiences of life. After attending the University of Wisconsin for 2 years, she went to New York, where she studied with W.E.B. Du Bois and wrote for Paul Robeson's Freedom magazine. Her marriage in 1953 to Robert Nemiroff, a white writer and activist, helped further to awaken her writing passion. 6 years later, her masterpiece was ready for its debut. Historically, Hansberry's play told an empirical truth. America's black community, from PhD to welfare recipient, were bound together by the fact that all were ordered to ride at the back of the bus. But with desegregation, blacks knew who they weren't. They weren't sons and daughters of slaves, and they weren't Africans. When the affluent and the professional moved into integrated suburbs, and their children attended integrated schools, the sense of community and ethnicity based on Jim Crow laws dissolved. What the play so prophetically showed was the need for, as black author James Baldwin put it, a profound articulation of the black tradition by new black leaders.
When Lorraine Hansberry wrote Raisin in the Sun, the basic question for African Americans was integration. Now, 50 years later, the African American community is divided along political and generational lines that Lorraine Hansberry could not have imagined.
2 years after the play debuted on Broadway, it was made into a movie with a brilliant James Dean-like performance from Sidney Poitier. Tragically, Lorraine Hansberry died from cancer at the age of 34, depriving Americans of all the tremendous stories she might have written, perhaps even contributing more to that articulation Baldwin called for.
The next three writers became American icons, pop figures in their own right. They were Joseph Heller, Kurt Vonnegut, and Truman Capote. Authors were now media celebrities in their own time.